Hi, I'm Senator Judy Ward, and I'm joined today with Officer Craig Garman, a sergeant with the Fish and Boat Commission. We're here in Norrie, in Blair Township, in Blair County, and let's talk about what we're doing here today.
Well, today, Judy's the first preseason planting of trout into the local waterway, which today is Poplar Run. Where these trout that were produced over at the Pleasant Gap Fish Hatchery were trucked here to this location for us and our volunteers to help plant these fish or stock these fish into this particular waterway.
And so the first day of trout season is April 18th. So we give them about, you know, 4-6 weeks to get accustomed to the waters and live in there and grow before people come in and fish, right?
That's correct. Yeah, we have so many fish have to get stocked into every trout stock water in the entire state up till the opening day of trout season for this particular area, which is April 18th. So what we do, depending on the water, the flow, the population in that area, the biologists determine how many fish go into these local waterways and what time of year they should be put in. Obviously, we need to get them in before the season. Some waters that have a higher quality, such as this, can hold trout longer. So we try to get them in the water a little sooner, where we know they'll be there for the opening day of trout season, which is coming soon, April 18th.
And so where did the fish come from?
Pleasant Gap, good patch out, Bell Farm.
Okay, great, great. And you raised them there?
Yes.
And then we're going to put them in buckets?
Yes.
And we've got some volunteers here that are going to help us put them in the stream and send them on their way, right?
That's right.
Great.
That's the goal.
Okay, awesome. Let's get going. Yep. Look how beautiful they are. Okay. Here we go. Ready? Look at them. This year, there's a few, I was helping stock. There's a few trophies in there. Let's talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, well, trophy trout are our brood fish. They're usually 3 to 5 year old trout. And we stock a certain percentage of those every year in with the 1 year old fish that are average 10 to 12 inches.
Okay.
The brood fish can be up to 25 inches. I've seen a few this year that were over 25 inches stocked into the water. So we're really trying something new this year and putting more of the brood, larger fish in. As a way to give back to the anglers and give them an opportunity to catch a very big fish. This here is a 3 year old rainbow trout, which we would consider a brood fish.
Beautiful.
Certainly a prize for any angler.
Just beautiful. My goodness. Okay, we're gonna get them in the water.
Very good.
Perfect. Craig, it's my understanding from fishermen that the one fish that they really like to get are the golden rainbow trout.
You're absolutely correct. These fish are like a prize to most anglers. A golden rainbow trout is also referred to as a palomino trout. It's a very brightly colored, almost the color of this license, that we have been stocking for numerous years. But this year we're going to increase the number of those fish going into these stocked waters by 40%.
Wow.
So that'll give anglers an opportunity to catch one of these palomino or golden rainbow trout, which actually is a sought after prize. So yeah, there'll be a lot of opportunities for that this year.
Let's talk about some other things that are new this year. You've decided to relax the requirements on wearing your fishing license on your hat.
Yeah, that is a huge change in a regulation that we have seen for a very long time with the Fish and Boat Commission. Whereas each angler that is required to purchase a fishing license up until this year had to display it on an outer garment. We the Fish and Boat Commission have done away with that regulation, so it is not mandatory to have that license displayed on an outer garment. You can keep it in your wallet. Now keep in mind, you can still display it. Nothing says you
right.
don't have to,
right.
but the law does not require you to do that anymore.
As long as you have it on you.
Absolutely.
That's great. In addition to the first day of trout, April 18th, there is a youth mentoring day the week week before. And this is a great way to get young folks interested and involved in fishing.
Absolutely.
Craig, let's talk a little bit about someone at home who might want to fish, might want to get a license. Talk about how we can do that, how they can get their license.
Well, a fishing license like you're holding there, Senator, it can be purchased at any issuing agent, and there are numerous issuing agents across the state. Some tackle shops, some larger outdoor shops do carry those. Mm-hmm. Or if you simply want to stay at home, you can purchase it online.
So Craig, if people don't want to, they have more questions and want more information, they can certainly get on fishandboat.com, or they can also come to my office or get on my website, SenatorJudyWard.com, and get more information about stocking and details about trout season in general. So thank you again for being here, and we appreciate it.
Well, we certainly appreciate the support that your offices have always given us.
Thank you.
So thank you very much.
Thank you.